you've ever wondered what happens when incompetence meets arrogance, then you have the answer in this current administration. Unfortunately, not only are they the most incompetent administration ever, but they're also arrogant with their incompetence. So let's consider the three cabinet positions specifically mentioned in the Constitution: the Prime Minister, the Minister of Finance, and the Attorney General. Previous Prime Ministers have given us majority rule, independence, national insurance, the Defense Force, COB, UB, freedom of press, and local government. But the only thing that Dr. Menes has achieved to date was to get swing with the Oban deal, when Oban sent an imposter, Peter Krieger, to sign the agreement. And when all was said and done, they ended up with 690 acres of crown land, and all we ended up was with a piece of paper with a fake signature on it. Speaking about paper, on paper, Peter is a CPA and has an MBA and is supposed to be our most qualified Minister of Finance. But after five downgrades, five blacklistings, one gray listing, and $4 billion borrowed with nothing to show, he has bought us to the point where our dollar is in jeopardy of being devalued. And as Attorney General, Carl knows that whenever an Attorney General gives the government incorrect advice, they must resign or be fired. The most recent example of this was 5 months ago when UK Prime Minister Boris Johnson fired Geoffrey Cox from the cabinet. Although Mr. Cox told the media on February 13, 2020, that he was leaving the cabinet at the request of the Prime Minister. But Carl has incorrectly advised the government on at least four occasions and is still in his job. And since he was previously fired by Ingram, I assume that he doesn't want to be the first cabinet minister ever to be fired twice. But he's hired two Africans as deputy and assistant director of public prosecution, who are from countries that are not on the list where lawyers can qualify for admission to the Bahamas bar. And these Africans are sitting in office with nothing to do. He's failed to draft the extension of the emergency powers, and the Governor General had to declare a new state of emergency. He's failed to have the Governor General summons the senators within the constitutionally mandated 5 days after the declaration of emergency, and the Senate had to be suspended until this was done. And he's advised that there was sufficient evidence to convict certain former politicians, and even appealed one case all the way to the Privy Council. And get this, the Privy Council, in my opinion, insulted the government with their response. They didn't even allow the government to fly up to London to argue the case in person, and the government had to send written submissions. And although most of the Privy Council's decisions are at least 20 pages or so, their ruling was on about half a sheet of paper. Less than one sheet of paper. So this is what happens when incompetence meets arrogance. And believe it or not, they're arrogant enough to ask you to give them another 5 years in office so that they could continue with their incompetence.